I'm Kristen Yorkidis. I'm a local science teacher here, and today I'm going to present a few Thanksgiving-themed activities that you can do while you are off school and maybe trying to digest a little bit of your meal that you might be enjoying on Thanksgiving. So a lot of people like to enjoy a turkey dinner on Thanksgiving, and there's a really unique structure that turkeys have, as well as some other birds, that we don't have, and that's a gizzard. And the gizzard is part of their digestive system, and its purpose is to help them break down their food, since they don't have any teeth to chew like we do. So it's a very unique structure. So we're gonna talk a little bit about it and also come up with a demonstration to see how it works. So because they don't have any teeth, when they eat their food, which is typically some leaves and succulents, and depending on the season, might be little insects and bugs and maybe some lizards, berries, whatever they can find, really, they don't care. So they have to figure out a way to break this down, because if they swallow it, you know, kind of like us sometimes when we don't chew enough, we choke on it, and your body really can't break it down. It needs to mash it up very tiny to actually get the energy out of your food. So the gizzard is really what helps turkeys and some other birds do that. So we're gonna do a little bit experiment. You're gonna need two little like baggies, so little Ziplocs would be fine, whatever you have. And you are gonna go out and collect some food that turkeys might eat. So I just went and picked up some leaves, and I had a berry type little bush in the backyard, and I got some little succulent leaves that fell. So I just went and picked up some different things that looked like turkey food. And I'm gonna put a little bit into each bag. So I'm gonna try and put a little bit of the same types of things. Get a couple berries in. And okay, so there's one. So there's one, you know, kind of meal right there. And then I'm gonna fill my other bag with some of the same things. Now, the gizzard is a muscular organ. So it, like a lot of muscles, it can really squeeze things really well. But the problem is, it can't squeeze everything. So as I'm filling these up, okay, we're gonna have two different conditions here. So one of them is gonna just be a plain bag with my food in it. And the other one, we're actually gonna add some little pebbles and anything that's kind of gritty. So it could be like a really hard shelled thing, or some little tiny pebbles. So I've got just some little tiny rocks here. So the turkeys will actually swallow some of these, and they'll get stored in the gizzard. I'm just gonna throw a couple in there. And they'll just kind of sit in the gizzard and these are gonna help us mash up the food. So our experiment is gonna see how well this gizzard structure actually works compared to just squeezing my bag like a muscle would squeeze the food. So I'm gonna start with this one. I'm gonna get some more of the air out so I don't pop it. So my hands are gonna be like the muscles around the gizzard squeezing food, which is very similar to some of the muscles in our digestive system squeezing food through, okay? And so when I do that, some of them break a little bit. The berries kind of break. Okay, so that's my first one. So some of the leaves are still kind of whole, some of them are kind of like cracked in half a little bit. So the one with the rocks in it, that's gonna represent our gizzard. Okay, I'm gonna do the same thing, squeezing. And we're gonna look and see if this makes a difference in how much the food is mashed up. Because if you don't mash the food up, the turkey isn't gonna get very much energy out of eating that food. And then they just have to go and eat more food. So it's really best if they can get as much energy out as possible. All right, so I kind of mashed them for about the same amount of time. I'm gonna hold them up kind of side by side. So this one, you've still got kind of some whole leaves in there. And this one, if we look kind of at the bottom where my rocks are lined up, some of them are broken up just a little bit more. And then this is one I did yesterday. I had, I think, some even smaller rocks in there. There's a lot more little bits, whereas the one that didn't have any rocks really kind of left more whole. So it's kind of a neat experiment to see, like, really what did adding those rocks do? So the turkeys actually go out and eat things that are kind of gritty, not for energy, but to store in their gizzard to help mash up their food so it can continue traveling through the digestive system and pull out that energy. So kind of a nice little, representation as we're talking about heading into, Thanksgiving meals and things, and turkey might be on the menu, but when they are out in the wild, they have these really cool structures that we can't even see from the outside, so a lot of people don't even know they exist. So that gizzard is really a unique structure that the turkeys have to help them eat their energy, get their energy and eat their food. So it's kind of a nice little demonstration that you can try at home, and maybe, if you've got some brothers or sisters or, you want to make it a competition of your family, see who can mash up their gizzard the best, and kind of compare what techniques you might have used. So that's something that you can kind of do as you're waiting for your Thanksgiving meal to cook. And then after your Thanksgiving meal, a lot of people kind of feel the need to maybe need a little walk to walk off some of those calories that they enjoyed. Now is a perfect time to go outside and look at the beautiful fall leaves that are changing colors. And so it's kind of a nice point in time to talk about, why do they change colors? Why do the leaves fall? Why can't they just be green forever? So I collected some leaves outside, and it's kind of like, okay, let's go for a little nature walk. So after you enjoy that nice Thanksgiving feast, you can go in the backyard, around the neighborhood, go to a park, and look for some really cool fall leaves. So depending on what type of tree or plant it is, we've got oranges and yellows and beautiful kind of burnt reds and things like that. So the reason why they don't just stay green forever, and this is only for some plants or some trees, is because there's pigments, there's colors in the leaves. So the green pigment is usually the most abundant pigment that you're gonna find the most in the plant. And this is from a pigment called chlorophyll. And chlorophyll's job is to collect the light from the sun so that the plant can make its own energy. So it's kind of this running theme right now this week is energy. So plants get to make their own energy. They don't need to go eat it like us and the turkeys. And so that chlorophyll, that green pigment inside the cells of the leaf, is actually collecting sunlight and helping do that photosynthesis process that plants are using to make energy from that sunlight they collect, the water they're absorbing from the ground, carbon dioxide from the air. So in the fall, when the weather's starting to change, the sunlight's just not out quite as long, you're not getting as much of that sunlight coming in, the plants start going, you know what, this isn't really very productive anymore. I'm not really making a whole lot of energy, and I have to use energy to make that chlorophyll. So I'm gonna take a little break from doing that photosynthesis, and I don't need to do it quite as much during the winter months. They've saved up some of their energy, and so they start reducing the amount of chlorophyll that they're making. And so when that happens, the green pigments start gradually going less and less and less, and it actually allows you to see those other colors that were always there, just not as much, not in as high of a quantity as that green chlorophyll. So kind of interesting, if you go for a nature walk and you can look at some of the different colors that are in the plants that you just weren't able to see because there was so much green everywhere. So there's a little activity, a little nature walk that I put together, and we'll include a link for a worksheet if you want to kind of put it on a clipboard and officially take a nature walk out looking for different fall leaves. And drawing them, the shapes of them, the colors that you see. And then kind of looking at, what patterns do I notice? Even though these different leaves came from different plants, there's some different patterns that can emerge. So I see kind of this burnt orangey color in a lot of my plants. I'm seeing some that are more yellows. So you can look for some patterns and look for, how many of the plants that you see are still green and how many of them are starting to change colors. So kind of a nice excuse to go out for an official walk after a Thanksgiving meal and you know, do some observations about the fall leaves and looking for those leaves that are now shining, those other pigments that are underneath all that chlorophyll. So, you know, like I said, good chance to get some science in between all that digestion of the, you know, big Thanksgiving meal and look at, you know, our changing landscape outside right now for the fall.